What's the plan, Kim and you?
Let's make it happen.
Igor, hey, got a second? Just talk to my, business partner on the radio.
What is it?
He's knee-deep in the shit. NAR is after him. But that's to be expected if you keep taking from them and giving unto yourself, huh?
I see. That kind of business.
Let's not get bogged down with the details. Just check if he's okay, would you? He's hiding somewhere near the Pripyat port.
Mikhail claims that everything is just business, but I know you can tell he's holding back the whole truth, can't you? There's a deep darkness within him, caused by loss and grief. Don't let it suck you in. Stay in the shadows.
Become invisible.
None of you are safe.
I should have brought that goddamn power bar. I'm starving.
Who's there? Don't shoot.
Relax. Mikhail sent me. Are you his business associate?
His what? Ah, yes. Sure. Sure thing. I've been shot. I need help.
Mikhail, I found your friend. NAR did a number on him. It doesn't look good.
Fuck! Well, help the man! I need him! He's got connections! Besides, he doesn't deserve to die like that! Like a dog!
Let me patch you up.
Thank you. I don't have anything on me. I had to drop everything when I ran. But I've got some intel you can have.
I'm looking for someone. Her name is Tatiana Amelieva.
She plays a violin, right? Sibelius.
Yes. My God, that's her favorite composer. You know her?
I can still hear the music. Beautiful. Inspired. Sibelius is not for everyone. Weeks ago, I started having the dreams. Only the music at first. Then I saw her. She didn't say anything, but I understood. She communicated with me through the music. My wife Katya used to play the violin, you see. That was our connection.
What did she communicate?
I wrote it down someplace, but it's still in my hideout. Probably swarming with NAR goons.
Don't go anywhere. I'm going to check your hideout. This is very important to me. You'll be fine. I promise.
Martin, you know this expression, Igor? You're like a foolish child wandering in the dark. You think you're getting closer, but the dark water is rushing in. Soon it will be over your head. You should have stayed away. You cannot ruin everything now. I won't allow it. So, want to show me what you're made of? Now run. I will hurt you if I have to. I'm giving you a 10-second head start. This is not going to end well for you. No.
Why did you have to come back? This is not going to end. Let's see what you're made of.
So, how is he?
Wounded, but he's gonna make it.
Oh, that's a relief. He has access to different goods and a lot of useful contacts.
Looking out for your fellow man, eh, Mikhail?
Fuck you, Mr. Righteous. Maybe this is some kind of romantic adventure for you, but some people have to make a living here.
How are things, Professor Kim Nuke?
Not too bad, Sashko. Not too bad.
I've been thinking about my brother Rustlin recently. He'd make a great addition to our team.
You were both in a street gang, right?
For a while, yes. We ran errands for Yuri Kibish, a dangerous gangster. He was fucking nuts too, of course.
I see.
I know you're trying to be polite, Igor, but there's no way to understand these things unless you've lived through them yourself. I'm talking about ongoing turf wars between every type of gang. Russian, Kyrgyz, Thai, Vietnamese, you name it. Everyone trying to get a piece for themselves.
What about the police?
They stay well away unless they have urgent business there. You know what I mean? Anyway, me and Rustlin were right in the middle of it. Every day, something was going down. You run, you sweat, you fight, you kill, you bleed. You get hooked on the adrenaline, like a drug. Rustlin had a special talent. He could make a person disappear without a trace. That would have come in handy around here on several occasions. We all followed a code, of course. Even wild animals have rules. You're familiar with the Thieves' Code of Conduct?
Where criminals forsake their families and dedicate themselves to crime?
That's right. Rustlin would never hurt anyone who wasn't in his way. But that kind of life takes you dark places no matter what.
You think it took its toll on Rustlin?
Possibly. That's why I have to face him, to find out.
Sir! Good morning, sir!
Stop calling me sir. What do you want, Mikhail?
I'm just fucking teasing you, man. Cause I'm bored. You used to live in England, didn't you? Eating your full English breakfast, drinking Darjeeling tea, scooting around in your Aston Martin, sipping martinis, mingling with high society. A regular James fucking Bond.
I ate porridge for breakfast, for Christ's sake.
Relax, I'm kidding. I did a piece of business with some Brits once. Good blokes. They drank Stolichnaya with Red Bull. Loopy fuckers.
Why are you wasting my time, Mikhail?
I knew a guy once. I used to do business in Moscow. This guy wasn't a Brit, he was Scottish. I think his name was Daniel. He was absolutely fascinated by the Moscow sewers. Daniel was looking for a guide, so I took him on a tour of the underground, told him some really top-drawer fucking tales about nuclear bunkers under the Moskva River where Putin will hide when the zombie apocalypse comes, about the lizard people from Zeta Reticuli controlling the amount of sugar in your Starbucks coffee. He was a tad skeptical, though. Reminds me of you, and that worries me.
Why?
You've spent too much time in the rotten capitalistic West, comrade. You know what I mean. Anyway, I hope our humble way of life isn't too much of a shock for you.
Oh, trust me. I'll always be Ukrainian in my heart.
Great! I'll drink to that. Yeah, as soon as I find something better to drink, that is.
Thank you. What's going on, Igor?
Got a sec, partner?
Shoot.
I know how to make small, shaped charges. Perfect for demolition locks.
Right. I can see that coming in handy.
But first, I need you to pick up the plastic left over from the Dugar radar operation.
Sounds like it's worth it.
I'm a practical man. I wouldn't go suggesting shit like this if it was just a waste of time. I built my first pipe bomb when I was 8. I can make a charge from just about anything.
How did such a promising young man ever end up here?
I've left some plastique in my old hidey hole, bring it here and I'll get it to work. Ready to go?
Sure.
I'll mark the building on your map. It's in the Duga radar facility. Let's do this.
Are we doing something or not?
Charges? I always knew that you had something explosive hidden inside of you, Professor Kimunu. Just be very careful, love. Once you help someone, you can easily become responsible for them.
Okay, Sashko. I'm in position.
You should find the place, no problem. It's in a one-way story building on the perimeter of the Muscovy.
I think I know where it is.
job right there. You're on Pripyat, bro.
You mentioned something. What kind of thing? What about this?
That'll be one food. You wanna fuck with the Bradford tour?
I better be going now.
Bradford forever!
Sashko, I found the plastic box, but it's empty. There are some droppings and... is it possible rats took your charges?
Well, shit, those sneaky bastards must have been really hungry.
Now what?
Well, no charges means more work for me and also more work for you. I can make the compound from scratch, but that means I'll need the ingredients from somewhere else. But first, we need to take care of the rat problem.
What do you mean?
You got the detonator? Press the button.
Why would I do that?
To blow these bastards to Rat Kingdom come. I don't want them running around with my charges.
All right, time to meet the great rat catcher in the sky, my furry little friends. Nothing? Shit.
You actually pressed the button? I'm impressed.
Nothing happened.
Of course nothing happened, Goofus. It's a dummy. But well, right? Igor Kimonyuk. Professor, lover, pyromaniac.
This was another of your idiot stunts? You know, I know I should be surprised, but actually I'm not.
It's not a real detonator, it's just a prop. I was just messing with you, Professor. Trust me, I wouldn't risk a life of my brave companion like that. But you still need to go to find my other stash and bring me the components I need. It's right next to the connector.
Sashko, I found the building, but it's crawling with NAR soldiers. Looks like they know about the stash. Any ideas?
fuckers. They must have spotted me earlier.
A little heads up would be appreciated next time.
Hey, you got this, man. You're better at this shit than you give yourself credit for.
Thanks, but...
You're breaking up. I'm losing signal. Igor, signal!
Sashko! Sashko! Damn it! Sashko, I found your components.
Glad to hear it. For a moment there, I thought I might lose my favorite partner in crime.
Was that supposed to be humor, Sashko? Not bad for a first try. Sashko, you know the difference between dynamite and nitroglycerin? I need you to be more stable, like dynamite, and less like nitroglycerin, which will just blow a person to hell for no reason.
You want to make an omelet? You gotta crack a few skulls, am I right?
If you know so much about eggs, how about helping out with the cooking?
Nah, that's your department. I'll stick to what I'm good at, blowing shit up.
Nothing much. I need to remember to check the dosimeters.
How are things?
Must fucking tell, Igor.
And good day to you, Mikhail. I saw you fooling around with some cards earlier. Are you a gambling man?
These are tarot cards.
Huh? Are you moonlighting as a gypsy? Where's your crystal ball?
Oh, let me think where I left it. Oh, now I remember. It's up your asshole. You don't like anything that doesn't fit with your mind-numbing scientific worldview, right?
I don't like superstitious nonsense without any basis in reason or fact.
You can bet your skinny little ass there are things around here that can't be easily explained. You should keep an open mind instead of just burying your face in books. The tarot can be a powerful fucking tool if you let it.
Okay, I'll bite. What does the tarot say?
I actually already pulled a card for you today. The Lovers! Nice! This card can have multiple meanings. There's the obvious one.
Me and Tatiana?
Very good. But it also means having to make a choice. One that will have consequences you cannot foresee. I'd have to pull a second card to get into it. Should I do that, Igor?
I think I'll stick with my mind-numbing scientific worldview. Thanks anyway.
Get up, Professor Kumunik. Time is of the essence.
What?
Meet me in Lenin Square.